NASA and Lockheed Martin have been laboratory testing to lessen the sonic impact of the upcoming X-59 supersonic jet. According to the agency, this small-scale process will help engineers work on the physical and the software solution so that the noise caused by the sound speed drop is less. According to NASA, a miniature X-59 with the same shape as a real model was placed in 2.5 meter by 1.8 meter supersonic wind tunnel. With the action of the air against the aircraft, it was possible to verify the shock waves produced by the friction. Cameras and sensors collected the results and determined the energetic force exhaled by the prototype. NASA's wind tunnel test researchers said, with the X-59, they want to demonstrate that they can reduce the supersonic boom to something much quieter than a supersonic thud. The crash test was filmed by US Space Agency with Schillerman techniques, which captures the visualization of the shockwaves formed by the frictions of the wind with the aircraft. Internal sensors located inside the prototype measured the intensity of the shock and revealed promising levels when scaled up to the full scale. The Schillerman images and the pressure measurement are critical for NASA to be able to compare with wind tunnel data with the computer modeling. The features improve the team's ability to understand and predict actual sonic beats during the futures of X-59 flights. If NASA manages to transform the booms into small sonic beats, we may have a change in the regulation for supersonic flights over the continent, which are now banned worldwide. It is worth remembering that the other companies continue to work on the development of supersonic aircraft, such as the Boom Supersonic, which has already negotiated some units with United Airlines. So what do you think? Can NASA fulfill a silent supersonic flight?